Just imagine being able to create a robot that can do something for you and you can just completely forget about it. That is what we're gonna do in this video. We are gonna create a robot that every single day it is going to make a LinkedIn post for us. Now it is going to search for the news, it is going to take this news, it is going to put it onto LinkedIn and post it for us. And it is going to do this forever, every single day until the end of times. Now, if you truly want to become the biggest wet willy of automation, then you have to have a robot that is completely automated. So let's check it out and see how it's built. We are gonna call our robot Social Twin, and we're gonna build it in different chapters. In today's video, we are gonna build just the basic and the skeleton for our robot. We are gonna start with part one, which is going to be to first post to LinkedIn. So we are gonna start by looking for a way to launch Google Chrome. So we're gonna carry the launch new Google Chrome action, and we're gonna add the LinkedIn feed URL. Now, if we launch our recorder and we record the different actions, we need to get the post. So we need to add a post to LinkedIn. So what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be sharing a post inside of LinkedIn, and we're gonna be getting some news to put inside of here. But for now, let's try spying the right elements. So when we're spying, we also have to make sure that we're always spying the correct element. In this case, I cannot get the right element. I cannot get a text box. So I have to get the closest thing that is to it. I can try different things, but since I cannot insert the text in that way, I will have to send a click. So let's spy the different elements and complete our recording. That is great. We completed the first part of our process. You can choose whatever news site you want. This is going to work with whatever news site you want extracting information. I'm going to go to the HuffPost and I will just get the first news title. So what I will do is I will again navigate to a different, this time I'm not going to launch a new Chrome, but I will navigate to a new page inside of the already opened browser. So I will navigate to this page and I will extract the news from this page. So I want to share the news title and the URL to this news. So the post that we're going to initially create in our skeleton application is just going to have the title of the news and the URL of the news. So let's extract that information. So using the web recorder, as always, I see I can get the text here. So I'm going to extract the text. That is the only thing that I need. I can also extract other things such as the text or the image, but I can't get the URL from here. So even if I select parent element and still I right click on this and I cannot get the URL in this method. So I have to be creative and I have to think of a different way of getting the URL. So what we will do is we're going to click on the URL and just extract the URL in this way from the URL of the browser. So we're going to send a click to the text that we managed to find, and we're going to extract the URL from the browser. So what we need to look for is a web data extraction, and we need to get the details of the web page. Now, with get the details of the web page, let's look for the URL address, so the current URL address of the browser. And now we have the text. We're gonna get the text, click on the text, and we're gonna go to the other page. And after that, we are going to extract the URL of the browser. So that's pretty much our process. It's pretty much almost complete. So the last things that we need to do is we need to perfect it a little bit, and we need to post this information that we found onto LinkedIn. So let's rearrange our process. First, let's change this URL. Let's add, first we're going to go to the news page, and after we go to the news page, we're going to go to the LinkedIn page. So let's remove also all of the comments that were generated for us and that we don't need anymore. Comments are always useful to keep in your process so that you can have a logical structure as well. So don't remove all of the comments. Maybe some of them you can rename the comment. So let's rename this comment and let's make our process a little bit more legible and understandable for later and future reference. So here we have LinkedIn. This is the bottom part of our process. This is when we're going to go to LinkedIn. First, we're going to get the news, and after that, we are going to go to LinkedIn. So the last thing that we need in LinkedIn, we need to send the text. So we need to send the information inside of our post that we managed to get. And after that, we need to click on post. So let's find the variables that we are extracting. So inner text is the first variable. And the second one is from the get details of page. So we are getting the URL right now, and we are inserting it dynamically. We're getting the title and URL. So let's see if this is going to work so far. So it is getting the news. It is clicking on the link successfully. And now it's opening LinkedIn. It is opening LinkedIn. It is clicking on the post and is writing the title, including the URL. Now, when the URL loads, the preview is loaded as well automatically. So what we need to do now is we just need to click on post, and the basic skeleton for our application is starting to take shape. Now, in the future videos, we are going to improve this news. We're not just going to put a title and a link. We're going to maybe create a custom video that we're going to post on this. So I have a robot already that creates custom videos. Maybe we're going to do something a little bit more interesting. So let's first spy this, and then we will think about some ideas that we could have in future videos. If anybody has an idea, please post it in the comments below. So if you want me to elaborate on this social twin that we are building right now, you can make your suggestions below. So now that we have spied the post button, we can finish this recording and we can go back to our process and pretty much finalize this part with LinkedIn. Now we need to do one more thing. We need to schedule our flow. So right now our process is almost complete. Let's rename all of the elements so that we have a little bit more structure and a little bit more logic, and we can make reference to it a little bit later as well. But going back to the topic that we're talking about, how we are going to improve the news. So we can do some sentiment analysis on the news and post the these details. We can do some syntax on and extract maybe entities and get the context of the news that is there. But we'll think about that in the later videos, and I will also read your comments. For now, let's finalize this process and let's move on to step number three. Step number three is going to be when we're gonna schedule our process. We're gonna schedule our process so that it runs forever. Remember how in the beginning we said that we wanna become the biggest, baddest Willy of automation and have a social twin that is gonna work every day. So let's go to cloud and let's create a new scheduled flow. So we're gonna create a new scheduled flow from scratch. And we're gonna call this flow whatever we want, but we're gonna make sure that it runs every day. So every day at 10 a.m., we are gonna make a post. And obviously we're gonna add a meaningful name to our flow. But apart from that, our flow is going to run every day at 10 a.m. The robot is going to get a new article every day from that web page and is gonna make a post about it. So we can forget about making posts. All right, I know that the article is pretty garbage right now, but it will be our mission to improve on it. And with AI Builder and with all of the different services that we have available, we can make it so much better. For right now, let's connect to our desktop. All right, looks like we have found the correct one. Now, when we connect to it, we are going to have access to all of our desktop flows, so we can choose the flow that we just created that we called post to automatically to LinkedIn. So let's post to LinkedIn automatically. We are going to connect it to this instance. So what is it going to do? It is going to be on a scheduled flow. And this flow, as long as this virtual machine is going to be turned on, this flow every day at 10 a.m., it's going to make a new LinkedIn post. Now, this is also great because currently there is no way that automatically with flow you can auto schedule flows for LinkedIn. You can do it for Twitter, but you cannot do it for LinkedIn. So right now we have replicated that functionality. So let's run our process one more time, and we see that it has opened the first part and extracted everything that it needs. Now it's just lagging a little bit and waiting to navigate to the next page, which is going to be LinkedIn. So let's give it a couple of seconds for it to navigate to the other page. And I always think that it gets stuck here, but it's actually processing the different things. So let's check it out. We can see that it is still running. All right, I am getting worried. All right, it is navigating to the LinkedIn page, and we can see that it has navigated there. It is putting the article that we wanted, and we put a breakpoint on post just so that we don't make the same post twice. All right, that is great. Let's do a couple of improvements. I know it has been a long video, and if you're sticking around, that is great. That means that you're really committed to learning automation, and thumbs up for you, RPA champion. Let's add a couple of weights just to make our robot a little bit more stable. We've tried this robot already a couple of times. So far, it hasn't failed. We haven't inserted any exception handling, but we will do that when the need arises. So when we see that it has failed, we're gonna check out what has failed, and we're gonna add exception handling around it. For right now, there is no need to do that. Let's just add a couple of weights around just so we make sure that once we send the keys to LinkedIn, all of the page is going to load correctly. If we add a link, we need to wait for the link to generate a preview. So let's wait for that. And also let's wait a little bit. That might be actually a little bit of an unnecessary wait, but if we have this in a loop, we might require that wait for further for in the future. So we can leave it there. So let's save our process, and that is pretty much it. We have created our process, a skeleton for our process, and now we can build on top of this. The first part that we're gonna build out, we're gonna improve the news part and how the news is posted inside of here. So let's also close our web browser all the way at the end of our application. And that is pretty much all that has to be done. Let's save it again. Let's remember that we have set a schedule for this process to run at 10 a.m. And ladies and gentlemen, RPA champions, give yourself a round of applause for completing the first part of this automation. You are truly an automation social twin that you want to create that is just great. It is going to help you in many different things, and especially save time and gain a competitive advantage. So I'm waiting for your comments down below to understand how we can improve this.